Hi, this is Simon. This is part two of a series on data bending and data moshing audio. Everything inside of our computer or any other digital system is made up of numbers. All of the videos you watch on streaming services, all of the music that's on your computer or iPod, all of the photos that are stored in your phone, those are all built on numbers, on data. When we're online, data is also constantly collected about us in order to target individuals for advertising or political messages. Many of these things happen without our thought or our knowledge of it. But by making art with data, by bending and distorting that data, we can create some sort of post-digital expression, forefronting technology and its imperfections, and making a kind of glitch art. Today, I'm going to be doing some data moshing, manipulation of compressed audio. Data moshing most commonly refers to the process of glitching video, specifically removing what are called iframes in order to create distorted effects. If you're interested in learning more about these effects, I've put some links in the description below. I'm not completely sure if playing with compressed audio technically qualifies as data moshing, but since this is a subversive approach to art, I'll leave those debates to other people. In this video, I'm going to be using Audacity again and a hex editor. For my hex editor, I'm going to be using a program called Hex Fiend, which is free, but it's Mac only. If you're not on Mac, I've heard good things about HXD and Fred, which are both free programs. Here we go. Here in Audacity, I have a guitar lick, which is uncompressed audio. This is just a fake guitar lick that I threw together for this video. Of course, you could just as easily record real sounds. As I said, this is uncompressed audio, so this is an AF file. WAV files and AFF files are uncompressed, meaning that they haven't gone through any kind of data compression. When we do data moshing, we want to use compressed audio, so MP3 is a very common compressed format, but what I'm going to do today, you could also do with Ogg Vorbis. I haven't tried it with Apple Lossless, but it could be interesting. It's important to remember that MP3 is a lossy form of compression, which means it looks through your audio file and thinks about things that it can throw away, information that it can discard without you noticing. While it's not data moshing, we can actually create a ridiculously compressed version of this. If I go up to File, Export as MP3, we have a lot of options on the MP3 quality that we could use. Generally speaking, currently MP3s tend to be about 160 kbps. This is kilobits per second. This is the amount of data per second they have. If you're an old timer like me, you remember that often with Napster and LimeWire, we had 128 kbps. We can just compress the heck out of this. We can go to 32 kbps. If you go lower than this, it's going to complain about a 44.1 file. So let's just start by doing 32 kbps and seeing what that sounds like. I'm going to put that in my for moshing folder here and save. We don't care about metadata. So here's that file, and here's what it sounds like now. We seem to have lost a lot of the high frequencies there too, so it's probably reducing the sample rate of the uncompressed audio. But you hear all those little sort of squeaky artifacts. Those of us who grew up with Napster or LimeWire will find this sound familiar. And as a lot of our human interaction is over Zoom or Skype now, we hear this a lot too. Let's get rid of that for now, though. Go back. Let's export. Let's export as a more reasonable MP3. So let's make this a variable bitrate. Let's make it reasonably high quality. Save. No metadata. Here's what it sounds like now. That's pretty good. Here's the original. MP3. Since you're listening to all of this audio over YouTube, which is compressing the audio anyway, those are probably indistinguishable. So what I want to do next is open this up with Hex Fiend. We're going to do some serious messing with this audio, and so it's a very good idea if we duplicate it first. Really, it doesn't matter. I could always get it back by re-exporting that MP3, but it might save me a step. I'm going to open this with Hex Fiend. Okay, so now we have a whole bunch of numbers that make up this file. These are hexadecimal numbers, which is why it's called Hex Fiend. I don't want to get too into it, but hexadecimal is a base 16 counting system. What it means is the numbers go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. And so we'll see all of those numbers in here. This is just a convenient way to represent bytes on the computer. If you're more interested in that, there are plenty of resources to dig into. So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of randomly change some of these numbers. And this is a long, long file, so what I'm going to do is go to the top here. Okay. Command A to select all of it. And then I'm actually going to hold down Shift so I don't select this very, very beginning part. This is the header of the file. And changing the header of the file can get you in trouble really quickly. So I'm just going to omit that. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go Command F, and it brings up this Find and Replace. Let's just pick something that we see. So for example, I see 6F here. So let me go to Find 6F and replace it with F6. Now this is completely arbitrary. I might break this file. I might make it so it's completely unplayable, but que sera sera, I've made that copy. I'm not too worried. Click Replace All. Okay. Command S to save. Now let's go back and see what we got. Now, I think that's kind of beautiful. So what I'm going to do in order to keep it is I'm going to go Command D to duplicate it. And so now I have this copy too. Open this one with Hex Fiend. Command A to select it all. Shift to get the header out of it. And let's choose something else to do. What should we do? 7A looks promising. So let's go Command F. Find 7A. Replace with A7. Replace all, save, copy two. Getting better. Copy three, open with Hex Fiend. Command A. This is going surprisingly well, by the way. Usually I've broken the file by now. Gosh, what do we have left here? I see an 81. Now, there's nothing to say I couldn't replace a string of four numbers with four numbers, or I could just cut things out of here. Usually you'll get the best effects by finding and replacing numbers. Replace all. Command S. Minimize. Copy three. You get this nice kind of spectral singing up there in the high frequencies. It's getting more and more crunchy. Command D to duplicate. Open with Hex Fiend. Let's do a couple this time because I think we need more rapid change. Command A, Shift. Okay, let's do find all the 1 1s and replace them with 2 2s. Replace all. Save. Okay. Find 6 7 7 6. Place all. And then we'll do CF4F F4. Replace all. Save. Close it up. And there's our datamoshed file. Here's our original. Nice to have some tension and release. Now, this is an MP3 file. In order to use it in a bunch of different programs, I can open it back up with Audacity and then export it back to uncompressed audio. This effect might be especially striking if applied to vocals, though it's important to realize if we use a variable bitrate MP3, we're going to affect the timing of these files, so after moshing, they might not sync up perfectly. This whole process is about trial and error, so you've got to be ready to fail. You're going to break some files, things aren't going to sound the way you want to, but keep at it, and you can make something great. I hope you have fun destroying some audio.